Again, I want to extend a big thanks from the Cal Poly football staff and Coach Walsh for all you guys for being here with us for the release of the recruiting class of 2015. We appreciate all of your efforts and also the efforts of all of our coaching staff and various partners here in town, which we'll also address and thank later. I want to start off with our highlight video. We'll go offensive players first, starting with the offensive line, and then we'll proceed through the rest of the offensive positions and the players that we signed, and then we'll move on to the defensive side of the ball. So I'm going to turn it over to our offensive coordinator, Saga Tuatelli, to address the offensive line.
Okay, up first we have Colin Goble. Colin is a transfer from the University of Iowa, from Naperville North High School in Naperville, Illinois. And the one thing you'll see here is this young man is very, very, very aggressive. Out of high school, he was rated, I believe, a three-star recruit by one of those publicists, and he had multiple Big Ten or Big 12 offers coming out of high school, and he chose to go to Iowa. But you can see why. He's extremely aggressive. He's got great pad level, and he's got he's able to. Stay on his feet, and he's got good hip explosion, so we're excited about Colin. Colin will be joining us in the spring. He'll have 3 years left of eligibility, and you see the balance that he has there and the change of direction, whether it's a run or pass. And this is a clip that's very, very similar to some of the schemes that we do as an offensive lineman, and as you see there, he can run, he can bend, he can get leverage, he can get underneath his defender. And again, he's a finisher. He tries to finish the defender. Okay, Paul Trujillo Langdon is one of the high school kids that we signed. He is a center. Okay, he's got the ability to play guard, but he's a big center, and it's extremely tough for us to find a true center in this system. But fortunately, he did both the under center and shotgun snaps. The one thing that you'll see with this young man is he has hips. He's got extreme knee bend, which forces him underneath his defender. And again, he's very, very powerful from the waist down. He's extremely young, so his upper body needs maturing. But as you can see there, he's very, very explosive off the out of his stance. And again, that it's a credit to his lower body strength, which is what we put a lot of onus on. So again, for us to get a young man that's be able to play center and guard is huge for us. And like you said, he can move. He played both sides of the line this year, including some guard. So we're excited to have Paul. And as you see here, he does some shotgun snaps and under center, but his ability to snap his hips and snap the defender's head back. Okay, Tyler Wisenhunt. Tyler Wisenhunt is a young man from California High School in San Ramon. And if you one thing you notice about him is he is massive. For our for our offense, for us to get a 6'4", 285-pound young man who can bend, who can strike, who is mean on the field, is extremely impressive. And Coach Kraft did a great job of recruiting him, and we were able to fend off New Mexico and UNLV for this young man. So he's got a huge upside because of his frame. He can play really all three positions, guard, tackle, and center. The one thing you'll see, he's got great balance for a big guy. So he's able to move his feet. And balance is good, especially in our offense when you're up on the second and the third levels trying to chase linebackers and defensive backs. Because of his size, he's got a lot of power. Again, not very strong in the weight room yet. Okay, but it's going to be a joy working with this young man and seeing him grow. Like I said, extremely massive, and he's able to move his weight all over the field, and extremely competitive. This young man likes to finish his blocks, and then he tries to get that secondary block, meaning after he takes that first block on, he goes on to the next. Okay, Coach Wood.
All right, next up. Quarterback Khalil Jenkins. I think every year if we could sign a quarterback like Khalil Jenkins, we'd be a happy crew of people. 6'1", 190 pounds. The size-speed combination as an athlete first that we look for in our offense, he has without question. I think oftentimes when you start talking about athletes that, fast, great change of direction, good size, can do those things, sometimes you find yourself compromising on their abilities to pass and throw the ball. And I think as you watch these things, you'll find that he's way further developed than a lot of the athlete-type quarterbacks that maybe you've looked at in the past. I'm really, really pleased with where he's at. Gone back recruiting process-wise, first all the way back to March, at a USA football camp, and then worked with him, all the way through. He's extremely productive in both phases, run game and pass game. One of the things as a decision maker, I love the fact that he had 24 touchdowns, I think, and 7 interceptions. Ball protection on offense is such a big component of who we are. Khalil has all the intangibles you look for in a quarterback, tremendous leader, tough kid, multi-sport athlete. Really has a great charisma about himself and really, really excited about who we're adding to the quarterback club this year.
In the wide receiver position, we have two stories. J.J. Koski here is San Ramon Valley High School, which is the home of Matt Fisher and Colin Blair, a couple of student athletes who are with us already. J.J.'s a big kid. He's 6'1", 185, 190 pounds. And this story, really goes back to his sophomore year when we saw him on a camp. And the coaches, Coach Wood, Coach Findle, they saw them, saw JJ, in spring and summertime at camps, and we kind of earmarked him. He came to our camp, did a great job. He honestly, numbers-wise, probably had a better year as a junior, but that kind of has to do with a little bit of the personnel of his team. Very fortunate here that he didn't have the numbers that he did his junior year. Honestly, we would have been fighting some bigger fish for him, I think. Montana, Sac State, Weber, NAU, all came on him, but JJ's a guy that stuck with us for a long time. He committed about October, November. Highly skilled kid, very polished wide receiver. We got to see him play live a number of times, so we're real confident that he can fit the needs in our offense. Jake Smeltzer here from Tesoro High School is kind of a different story. Again, Coach Wood did a fantastic job with Jake because we had a commitment out of JJ, and Jake here is a guy that, quite honestly, you can't pass up. 6'2.5", 6'3", very athletic, catches the ball well, runs very well. Again, a lot of offers in conference that we had to battle against with a wide receiver already committed. So for us to get Jake while having a commitment with JJ, it goes back to the job that the area recruiters and Coach Tuatelli, Coach Wood did, kind of keeping Jake warm and keeping him ready if we decide to go on him, and we did. He said yes, and he's going to be a great attribute as well. Both these guys are polished. Both of them are very good ball players as far as like in the air, body control, great hands. They have the size we need for our offense. They're big kids, and as you can see, they can run. We're really excited about what these two guys bring to the table as wide receivers. Both of them are excellent students as well. They'll both be business majors. Jake and JJ, chose Cal Poly for a number of reasons other than, what we do on the football field. They're great students. And here's Coach Aristotle Thompson.
All right. Start off talking about David Cooper, running back from Loyola High School. When you take a look at David on film, what you're going to see is a guy with really good balance, good vision, and a burst of speed as well. You talk about guys that can change the game in various ways, and this is a player who does that on any given play. He's a two-way starter down at Loyola High School, playing for head coach Marvin Sanders. Running a really good program down there. Got an opportunity to go see him live and play in a game, and was just wowed by what he did on the field. David is a guy that had Mountain West looks as far as scholarships and whatnot, but really came into play with us here at Cal Poly, just the way we're persistent in recruiting him, but then also having a player in Makai Sheffy, who went to high school with him, is really good friends with him. Also, coming from a really strong academic family, they understood the value of what a Cal Poly education would mean to him for a guy who wants to go to law school after completing his undergrad degree. So with that said, Cal Poly was somewhat a natural fit for him, and it was a matter of him getting more to understand about what we do on the field, how we play, the style of football that we play at Cal Poly, suited for any running back, regardless of what style you've played in high school. You're going to love to run the ball. When you're rushing for over 450 yards per game, leading the nation in rushing, you want to be a part of it. Raven Middleton from Sweetwater High School. Raven is a big body back. Okay, we wanted to fill some depth there at our H position. and losing a guy like Brandon Howell last year, Gabe Umo the season before. We went after Raven Middleton because he fit those needs, but also he brings a burst of speed. So what you'll see in Raven is a guy who's playing a wing position, running a similar offense to what we do, some different blocking stuff with it, but we will put him behind the quarterback as our H back there and let his big body go. He's about 215 pounds, about 6'3". And this is just a kid that as you guys have come to learn more about him, you'll want to put your arms around him. He's a special kid, very bright, gifted, and very giving young man, very mature beyond his age of 18 years. Has dealt with a lot of situations within his life and has persevered throughout it. And you see what we really like about him is that leg drive and forward lean, very similar to a Jake Romanelli from a few years back. You know, but also has the burst of speed that you got in a Gabe Umo as well. So really excited about Raven and what he's going to bring to the table for us in playing for Cal Poly football. Hoping to see one of these runs here where you get to really see him play behind his pads. And I think that's something you'll see with all of our backs here. Trey Nahas, unbelievable player. Sacramento Bee. Offensive player of the year, so he's the best offensive player in the Sacramento area, and you have a number of guys who are going to FBS schools that he was picked ahead of them. What you'll see from this kid is a guy who has it both. He's inside and outside. He's a straight line guy, but can bend and change directions. And if you get in front of him, he's going to deliver the boom on you as well. He has the speed to do it. He was the South Squad MVP for the Sacramento Optimist game, so the all-star game in the Sacramento area, he was rated as the top player on his team. And you talk about a guy who knows how to run the ball. He rushed in his senior season, rushed for 2,500 yards in senior season, okay? Really is 26, is 1 yard shy of the 26, had almost 3,000 yards of total offense. I mean, the guy is just a phenomenal player, 4.0 student, biomed engineer major. You know, he's a guy that was interested in Cal Poly as early as the seventh grade. So he's done his homework. He knows what this place means, and he will be a good asset for us. DJ Palusa, okay. This guy is a transfer from the College of San Mateo up in the Bay Area. This is a guy that Coach Jim Kraft had been recruiting for a while and just kept staying on this guy and kept knocking down our door saying, hey, you got to take a look at this kid, take a look at it. What you're going to see from this guy is a guy who's a little more polished in our option scheme. So at San Mateo, they run our under-center game, triple option. So he has done both the blocking part of it, but also carrying the ball. And what you'll see from here on his film is him really being explosive, being great leg drive, good balance. You take a look at this run, just watch the fight that he has here. I mean, just staying alive, fighting through. And if anybody knows junior college football in the state of California, you know that he's not playing against any slouches. These are not bad football players that he's going to work on. You know, he also brings a burst of speed, as well as you'll see on this kick return, see him reversing field and trying to go to the house with this one. And one thing you might not see so much on this film is that this guy is a devastating blocker. You know, we had Cole Stanford a few years ago who was a pretty good blocker, and this guy brings the blocking ability of a Cole Stanford, but mixing in some of the running ability at times of a Deontay Williams, Jake Romanelli, some guys like that. So we do have high expectations for it, you know, to say the least. We expect him to come in and compete to start right away. We're not waiting for him to be sitting down this year. With that, I'm going to turn it over to Coach Josh Brown to talk about our linebackers and the rest of the defensive staff. We'll proceed from there.
Okay, like Coach Walsh already addressed a little bit, obviously we had a need at linebacker to build some depth, actually, for our position group there. And we feel like Charlie Davis, and I'll talk about some of the other guys here in a sec, but Charlie Davis went to San Leandro High School, and then he went to Laney Junior College. Coach Enna recruited him out of Laney Junior College. We watched him throughout the year. And the thing that, when you guys watch this film, the thing that pops out the most is obviously his speed. He's a guy that we think can kind of fit the mold of a Cameron Onko that can really run and do some things out in space. He's kind of a unique situation. In high school, he was truly an outside linebacker on the line of scrimmage every down. He played that at Laney his freshman year, as you can see right there. He was kind of more of a rush linebacker. They felt like they had a need to get him to inside linebacker, so they moved him to inside linebacker this year. Kind of see here, it's freezing up on us, but but he can really, really run. And, you know, he's going to be a little bit raw at the inside linebacker position, but he does have all the tools. He's got the, he's got good length. He's got good speed. He's got good hip pop, all those different things that, that'll make him a good player here. You can see him run and chase down guys there. He is 3-for-2, so he does still have a redshirt year available if we needed it. And like I said, he's got some position versatility. He can play outside. He can play inside. Okay, Nick Navarro. Nick's from Yurupa High School down in Fontana. Great player, and you'll see the differences between the two here. Okay, obviously, you know, Charlie, long, athletic, can run. If you look at Nick here, he's very, very physical, and he can run too. He's one of those guys that we kind of say he's such a good player. We don't know exactly where he's going to play right now. It could be inside linebacker. It could be our rush slash defensive end position. We just felt like he was such a good player, we couldn't pass on his ability. Okay, and if you kind of look at him here, he's a little bit different than the last guy we watched. He's more physical. And you see, obviously, a little bit more size than Charlie right now as a senior in high school. Okay, he was MVP of his league down there, and obviously, you guys that know high school football, the Inland Empire down there, really good football, and he does a lot of different things. You see him rushing off the edge, see him playing true inside linebacker, dropping in coverage, all those different things that we ask our linebackers to do here, and he was recruited pretty heavily by our conference. You know, the Montana States, the Sacramento States. So he was very heavily recruited and felt like that Cal Poly was the best fit for him. And like you can see on his film there, he's a special player. Chris Santini, transfer from Boise State. He's from San Jose, California, went to Leland High School. Very, very heavily recruited out of high school. He had multiple Pac-12 offers. He had multiple Mountain West offers. And he ended up choosing Boise. Okay, obviously you guys that know the program, his brother played for us, Michael Santini, played linebacker as well. And Chris, throughout this whole process, I mean, he started every single game at Boise State in the last 2 years on special teams. So he's got a lot of game experience. He can really run, and he is physical. We didn't put any offensive clips on here because I didn't want Coach T to steal him for offense. But he's a very good athlete. He can run the ball. He does a lot of different things athletically that really impressed us. And on top of that, he's a great kid and comes from a good family, a good student, all the things that we're looking for. He was Mountain West Player of the Week for special teams versus San Diego State, I believe, in this past fall here. And like I said, we have big expectations for him, and we think that he can come in and contribute and compete for a starting position right off the bat. Look at him playing safety there. Okay, so that shows you what kind of athletic ability he does have. For us, he'd probably be a Sam or a Will linebacker for us. You know, he's going to play inside the box and also be able to play outside the box, possibly do some of the things off the edge. Here's Coach Anna to do the defensive line.
Cutler Solomon. Okay, this kid was on our radar early. Coach Brown had been in touch with him quite often throughout the recruiting process. We got to know him pretty well. So he's up there at St. Mary's High School in Stockton. And if you followed football in that area, you saw that they were 12-2, had a highly successful football season, and they're a school that historically plays good football. He's well coached, well trained, and boy, I'll tell you what, at 6'5" and about 250 pounds right now, these are the kind of young guns that you want to get your hands on early and kind of mold to your system, mold to the techniques that we want him to do. And by what we've seen out of him so far in high school and you know, getting to know him as a kid, this kid has a very, very bright future here at Cal Poly. Like Coach Walsh mentioned when he did his introduction, his parents are both Cal Poly grads, so when the heavy recruiting business came, he was very interested and stuck with us through the process. Here's Coach O with the DBs.
Cameron Dennis is from a Cal Poly family. His older brother, Carlton Dennis, is one of our starting corners from this past year. Cameron is what I really like about him. He's an aggressive guy, and he's willing to come up. He came up to camp as a sophomore and as a junior to show us his skills, even though his brother was already here. He's an aggressive corner, good footwork, and he's a willing tackler. He has 50 tackles his senior year and a fumble recovery. you know, we're really excited about Cameron. We believe as a Cal Poly family, you know, he's going to be able to do what we do here, which is win championships on the field and also be successful in the classroom. As you watch some of this film here, I mean, he's playing top-notch football here, you know, covering the best guys. He's also able to make a play on the ball in the deep balls. Jerick Rosales is a transfer from DVC up north. He's a cornerback from high school from De La Salle. Jerick has big play abilities to make a play on the ball, as you see on this film here. Okay, he's a 6'1". He's a 6'1 corner, and we're looking for him to be impactful in this upcoming fall. As the film rolls here, you see he's being used in different situations. He's also a willing tackler. He's one of those guys that we're looking for to, you know, looking at to be able to make a play on the deep balls and also be able to shore up the nub edges as far as corner play goes. It's not too often that you come across guys that just has a nose for the ball. All right, it's not a surprise. All the clips that you see with this kid, he's making a play on the ball. He has that ability, and none of the clips are on here. But as far as high school, he also played on the offensive side of the ball, and also it definitely shows as you watch this film here. I'm gonna pass it to Coach Fendel, our DB coach.
All right, Darren's one of our safeties from Bakersfield Junior College, Liberty High School out of Bakersfield. And obviously one of our points we had to address in recruiting was we had to get some size, some length in the secondary. You're going to see some guys come in here that don't look like a lot of the guys we've had the last couple years. Darren's one of them. 6'1 and some change, 190 type of guy, long arms. You know, out of high school, Coach Brown recruited him. He was kind of a tweener by position. We weren't sure if he was an outside backer. Was he a safety? Him going to Bakersfield was kind of a blessing for us because we got to see him play safety in a lot of the schemes that we do. So he really proved he can be a good athlete at the safety position. He's a physical player. He's going to be counted on to fill on the run game, wrap up and tackle. He's got all kinds of athleticism. His best years are still in front of him. Talking with his coach there, he's got a huge upside, and we think he's going to really come into that potential here at Cal Poly. Kevin Griffin, a unique story. Obviously, when you read about it in the press release, we don't talk a lot of three-star recruits, you know, number 50-rated cornerback in the country out of high school. Went to Washington State. They pulled his red shirt. He finished the year playing in three games. This is a kid that we think could come in and play nickel, safety, or corner for us. He's a ball player. If you guys that follow track, this kid as a junior in high school ran a 48.2 in the 400 and a 22.4 in the 200. He can flat go. And he's 6 foot and change and all of 190. Good looking body. He's a physical football player. He'll come hit you. Like I said, he could do a lot of things for us. So we'll utilize him in a lot of different spots. If you read the paper today, he has some high aspirations, and we have some high aspirations for him. And he's got kind of a mentality we want, too. He's a guy we think, with his play, can really elevate our secondary and kind of say, hey, we're here to be the best, and that's what we're going to be. That's the kind of moxie we were after. And he's been there and done that. You know, a couple state championship games at De La Salle and played in the Pac-12. So we're going to push him hard. He's still going to have to earn it while he's here, but we have some real high expectations for him. Katu Humphrey from Long Beach Poly, again, another kid who's played at a high level in high school. And as you watch film on this kid, and it starts with the first clip, this is what we couldn't bypass. He's not your 6'1", 190-pounder. He's your 5'9.5", 5'10", kid, 180, but he can flat play. And we kept coming back to him. And it was one of the guys, he didn't have all the measurements you want when you start out on the recruiting trail, but he was too good and he kept doing too many things for us to pass up on. He makes plays on the ball. He will strike you. His trigger, one of the things we look for in film, when a kid reads a play and is decisive and goes on the ball or the ball carrier, that's something that's really hard to measure as far as ability in high school. And Kitu has it. He's one of those guys that plays bigger than he is. He plays faster than he runs. He's our kind of guy. He's like some of the guys we've had here that have been successful in the past. So I think when this guy gets in our system, you know, spend a year redshirting and developing. He's a great young kid. He's going to make a lot of plays in the green and gold. He can flat get it done. So that's a guy that, again, we kind of, man, we just can't keep passing on this guy. We had taller, we had bigger, but he was a heck of a player. So as you can see in our secondary, we've kind of addressed the needs we wanted, and we think we got some guys who can come in and fill those holes. Coach Thompson.
So that's the class of 2015. As you see, 19 players signed in that class. Pretty excited about those guys. Right now, we're going to turn it back over to Mr. Burdick here and Coach Walsh for some questions, and then we'll wrap it up shortly after that.
Okay, first of all, I'd like to just...